Putting green core aeration is being performed at many golf courses across the region. Many golfers dislike core aeration because it can result in a temporary disruption in surface smoothness on the putting greens for a few weeks, but it's an extremely important agronomic program. Core aeration is the best method to remove organic matter and infuse a significant amount of sand into the upper 2 to 4 inches of the root zone profile, which creates a healthier environment for the turf root system. Too much organic matter can create soft, spongy playing conditions with inconsistent smoothness and green speed. Despite all the benefits associated with core aeration, golfers often feel that the short-term disruption to the playing surface makes the greens unplayable for a few weeks. In reality, most core aeration setups only impact 4 to 8% of the surface area in a single treatment. That means, on average, more than 90% of the surface is still smooth immediately following core aeration. We conducted a fairly simple test rolling 5 golf balls off of a stint meter a few days before core aeration and the day after core aeration. The golf balls were rolled on the exact same line to the exact same hole location. As you can see, we made 5 out of 5 golf balls before the green was core aerated. After the green was core aerated, we made 4 out of 5 golf balls in the same hole location. The point is, when core aeration is performed, as long as the aeration holes are thoroughly backfilled with sand afterwards, the putting greens are very playable and golfers can make putts, despite the fact that the greens might look very bumpy. Also, golfers should keep an open mind about the playability of a recently core aerated green, and although the golf ball might bounce around a little more than usual, who knows? Maybe the ball could bounce in your favor. For more information on core aeration, visit the Course Care tab on USGA.org.